a little time we meditate on the word. You know, John chapter 9 was speaking to me. I was going through a definite need, and really I was studying the Bible, and God spoke to me through these words. So I thought I will share little things with the same thought what God has given to me. Now here we see, now as Jesus was first, now as Jesus passed by, he saw a man who was blind from birth. And his disciples asked him, saying, "Rabbi, who sinned, this man or his parents, that he was born blind?" The amazing thing is here. Jesus answered, "Neither this man nor his parents sinned, but that the works of the God should be revealed in him." Hallelujah. Sometimes when we go through some unheard, unanswered prayers, or go through some troubles which we cannot express even to others, now we have a God who is able to answer. Now we cling on to him more and more. You know, this probably Jesus and his disciples was passing by. There was a synagogue, and people gathered in the synagogue to hear the word of God. So Jesus went and saw this man. He and his parents, we see that in the parable, that he and his parents, some Jews, Jesus' disciples, everywhere, everybody was there. But Jesus came to know that this is the purpose that I have come to this place. He saw this man, blind man. By birth, he was blind. And we see that he was a beggar. He was begging there. Even then, his parents were there. But he was begging. Probably in the gate of synagogue or inside the synagogue, he was begging. Then Jesus' disciples asked him, "Lord, how come, we already read, how come this man has become blind? Is it because of his sin?" Sometimes, you know, we blame others for the things happening in our life, in others' life. You know, the first person, as Adam did the same thing. Eve is the one who did everything. God asked Eve. Eve did not say that, "Sorry." She said, "Satan deceived me." The same thing is continuing, because we are all children of same inheritance. You know, we point out others. See here, Jesus is again, verse 4 say, "I must work the works of him who sent me while it is day." It is day. In daytime only, people work. Jesus is referring, the night is coming while when one cannot work. He speaks about his crucifixion. He has got time to do his amazing mission in this world, which is sent by his Father. And he is telling, "I had to do work. So my work is that. This in him, the work of God should be revealed." So what he said, "As long as I am in this world, I am the light of the world." Jesus said, "As long as I am in this world, I am the light." Beloved, I tell you, you are the light of this world. You are the salt of this earth. God has chosen each one of you in different time, by name, to show for this light to the world. The world is full of darkness. Wherever you see, evil things are there. Immoral things are there. But praise God that God has relieved you. God has chosen you from out of all these things, and he placed you in the heavenly realm. You are the light of the world. Today, each one of you are the light of the world. We must thank God. The Spirit is speaking to me. Somebody desperately have come here this morning for some healing, for some word of God, for some deliverance. I tell you, this is the word for you. This man is talking, I'm the light of the world. He's none other than our Lord Jesus Christ. He's the true. He is the true. If you believe, you will see the deliverance. You will see the healing. In the word 6 we see, when he had said these things, he spat on the ground and made clay and saliva and on the anointed the eye of the blind man with the clay. What he has to do, he has done. He went and spat and made it a clay, applied, and he said, go and wash in Siloah. He obeyed. Sometimes the problem is this. The word of God will come to us. Definitely God speaks to us through his Holy Spirit. But the problem is that to receive. Morning also in the church, we saw that obedience is better. Now when we obey, the things will change. Things will start changing. Until we obey, it will remain. Even the whole Bible you go through, the change, the situation will not change. If you obey one word, if you take one word, your situation will change. God will change. This fellow, this man, blind man, when Jesus applied, he said, he do not know much about Jesus. But when Jesus said, he went and washed. We see that in the seven last, we see he went and washed and came by seeing. Praise the Lord. Sometimes, you know, we may be believers since many years, or we may be just, you may be entered to this church. Beloved, I tell you, it is not an accident, it is appointed by my Heavenly Father.
Hallelujah.
You are the right place. But only the problem is, sometimes we will be still like this born blind man. So we can ask the Spirit of God, God, open my eyes. I want a balm to be applied by my Lord Jesus Christ. You know, you can ask. God knows your blindness. Which area of your blindness God very well knows. And you also know. You ask God. He is ready to apply his balm upon you. He is all the time is available for you. And obey and go and wash. We see the next part is amazing for me. What happened is that he came back. The verse 9 says, 8 says, the neighbors previously had seen and he was blind, said, is not this who sat and begged? And 9 says, some says, this is he. Others said, he is like him. And he himself says, no, I am the same. Hallelujah. You know, when God touches you, I tell you, with one touch, your situation changes. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Nobody in this world can hold on you. Somebody says, maybe he may be like him. Others says, no. He is not like him. And he himself says, yes, I am he only. Then comes the problem for him. Tenth word says that, therefore they said to him, how were your eyes opened? He said, I just know a man called Jesus spat on the clay and applied over my eyes and asked me to go and wash at Siloah. I came by sea. He knew only Jesus by name because he was a born blind. He don't know anything about Jesus. Somebody said that Jesus is this person who applied the balm on your eye. That much only he knew. He obeyed him. Next thing. Next is the problem. No, they did not leave him there. Let him go. Anyway, healed blind man by birth. He is healed. Let him go, enjoy the life. No. They took him. To where? To the Pharisees. The 13th word we see. They took him. They did not leave him there. They took him to Pharisees. And Pharisees again started questioning him. How did this happen? Because Pharisees came to know this Jesus. Somehow they wanted to say that Jesus is not a son of God, or Jesus not a Christ, or Jesus not a sent Messiah. That is the only thing they wanted to prove. That's why they already planned. They came to know this is a miracle happened. Since earth, this not, they never heard, never saw a blind man by birth is opening and seeing his eye. But they wanted to see that, first of all, they decided this is a Sabbath, day of Sabbath. So Sabbath day, no man of God can do such a miracle things according to their understanding. You know, Jesus Christ is the Lord of Sabbath also. Amen. He wanted to prove that. He wanted to open even the Jews and the Pharisees' real eye because they are the blind people. So he said, they already decided. No, this fellow cannot be. He is a sinner. That's why it could not be done. Secondly, we see him. So they summoned again to this man. He called, I'm going fast. He called and said, how it happened to you? How your eyes were opened? Then he said, who has opened? Then he said, he's a prophet I know. He opened my eyes. He sent me to such and such a place after applying the balm. And I went and washed and I came by seeing. I know he is a prophet. Look at him. He first knew only Jesus. Second time, he came to know only a prophet can do such a miracle. He realized his level of faith increased. Beloved, when we go through certain things, no, we should not be rolled away. We should stand on firm on our promises. Stand on our Lord Jesus Christ. He is never fails. He is the true God. If he says yes, it will be yes only. He came to know that he is a prophet. And now, the Pharisees are not ready. They summoned his parents. His parents was asked. Because already he decided, this man and this parents will be cast out from the synagogue. Or they will be made outcast. I'm going fast. So, the parents also came to know the talks, probably in the synagogue. That if you go and tell that so and so healed, probably they will cast you out. Then they feared. Parents feared. Sometimes it happens. You know, when the Holy Spirit touches you, when you receive Jesus Christ as your Lord, and you decided to walk as his disciple, you know, there's so many oppositions will come. First, it will come from your family. Second, from your congregation. Third, your community. You know, wherever you work. From so many ways, the opposition will come. Beloved, this man also, even father and mother denied. We see that because of the fear of the Pharisees. They said, we do not know. He is of age. You ask him. Only thing, he was our son and he was born blind, but now he sees. You ask him. So they escaped from the problem. They don't want to be a part of this man's problem, though he is a bona fide son. Sometimes our life also will be like that. You know, all people will be left out. But we have a God. He never leaves you nor forsakes you. When you testify him among the people, he will testify among with the angels. No, in front of angels, he will tell that he is my beloved son. He is my beloved daughter. I love him. Beloved father and mother may forsake you, but this God, whom we serve, he never forsakes you. In any situation, you may be going through the fire, or you may be going through waters, but this God is a God of mercy. He will lift you. You may not be walking in water. He may be walking in the hand of our Lord Jesus Christ. Even though you walk through the fires, it will not burn you because Jesus will cover you. Finally, we came to know. See, he is summoning to the this thing. He said, one verse, 27, he says, he answered them, I told you already, and you did not listen. Why do you want to hear it again? Do you want to become his disciples? Now, by the time he became disciple of Jesus Christ, he decided to follow Jesus Christ. So Pharisees, he again, third time, they're asking. So he is asking, do you want to become his disciple too? Then they have an answer. No. You are a disciple of this man. But we are who, you know? We are the disciples of Moses. You know, sometimes, you know, the tradition holds us to know the truth of God. Beloved, I tell you, these are the days of the Elisha. Days of Elisha. You know, the Spirit of God is pouring upon the people. Now, if you don't respond and realize, you know, God will pick someone else. These are the days that God is looking. Who is there available for me? You know, I am not looking some small congregation like this. You know, my vision is a big congregation. A people, thousands of people who can able to equip and go out and preach the word of God. You know, in the days to come, God will raise up. You know, all beginning is a small beginning. Humble beginning. God is looking an obedient people. God is looking who can able to go. A willing people. God is looking a spirit-filled people who can conquer for me. You know, finally we come to know. I'll close it because I already exceeded my time. Jesus says to him, 35, do you believe in the Son of God? He doesn't know who is Son of God. Jesus came to know that he was cast out from he was cast out from the synagogue. So Jesus appeared to him again. Do you believe in Son of God? He said, who is he, Lord, that I may believe in him? And Jesus said, you have both seen him and you are talking to him. Beloved, sometimes we also like this man. We do not know whom we are talking, whom we have seen. You know, our blinds. Ask this morning. I'll encourage you. Ask the Lord. Lord, let my spiritual eye be open to see your fullness of the glory in my life. What the purpose you have called me. Let this purpose may be accomplished through me. Not for our thing. Let God give us power to do the work of God. Let his name be glorified all the time. Thank you.
Very powerful expressions. God's plan for us. He did not know that many of you there have come with a desire to be healed. He didn't know that, but when he preached, the Holy Spirit told him, thank you. We're going to minister. You had a wonderful word. We don't have to keep on adding on to words. You had a wonderful time. Lift your hands and praise. And you'll see ministry happening now. I told you. Can you give a little bit? One of the things which Pastor Bogi said, these are the days of pouring out the Spirit of God. When the Holy Spirit comes upon you, not only will you get power, that power will come all over you and heal you. When the Holy Spirit comes upon you, new opportunities begin to open. That is, the power of God begins to open opportunities. If any of you have been down, I don't know how to go forward, today, receive the Holy Spirit. Move forward. If you are stuck somewhere, don't give up hope. God is going to open a door for you. These are the days of Elijah, declaring the word of the Lord. These are the days of the Jairus being restored. And though these are days of great trial, of famine and darkness and sorrow, still we are the voice in the desert, crying, prepare the way of the Lord. Behold the cloud, riding on the cloud, shining like the sun, at the trumpet call, lift your voice, year of jubilee, and God is Zion's hill, salvation comes.
It's
happening.
And these are the days of your servant, rebuilding a temple of praise.
And these are the
days of the harvest.
The fields are as white as the
wool. And we are your laborers in your vineyard, declaring the word of the Lord.
Be holy,
come,
riding on the
clouds.
At the trumpet call, lift your voice, the year of jubilee, and out of Zion's hill salvation comes. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise God. God is going to lift this church up. You and I are going to see the mighty hand of God. Yesterday evening, the Lord told me when I was praying, do you know that the one who does amazing things, his mighty hand is with you. A miracle working God. Church, we don't run after miracles. Miracles run after us. Amen. We're going to get ready for something awesome. But before that, I have to quickly ask Brother Cherian, don't sit down. Quickly ask Brother Cherian to tell you something which is of utmost importance. We are going to move into a time of worship. Many of you will see deliverance right now. Are you ready for that? Yes, Brother Cherian, quickly. Thank you.
Praise the Lord. 2-3 announcements. All the meeting for this week will be continue as usual. Then a special meeting this Saturday morning, 11 a.m. We have a special meeting in Brother Cyril and Prida's house at the 11 a.m. Then the end of this month, 27th, Friday, we have a whole night meeting. More details will be given in the WhatsApp. Then tomorrow, a special announcement for the youths. Tomorrow, 5 p.m., a youth meeting will be going to held on Shiju Brothers' house. So all the youths should go there by 5 p.m. And another notice from Pastor George, those who gave a donation for 2016, the receipt is ready for tax. They can please collect from Pastor George. Thank you.
It's clear? All right, let's give the Lord a clap offering. I love it when people just thump, come, thump. Thank you. Thank you. Awesome. Let's sing this. Okay, saints, you heard the word. You can open your eyes. This happened to you not because somebody sinned. so that the glory of God may manifest in your life. Many times we ask God, why? You heard the answer today. This is the reason why, that my glory may be manifest. Come on, let's sing that song.
There's no God like Jehovah. 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 Servant Moses, righteousness being restored. And though these are days of great trial, of famine and darkness and sword, till we are the ones in the desert crying, preparing the way of the Lord. Behold the cloud, riding on the clouds, shining like the sun, oh, at the trumpet call. Going to get healed today. Do you believe that? Some of you are going to be set free from oppression today. Somebody looking for a job, God is going to give you a job this week. But is anybody looking for a job? I sense in my spirit somebody was desperately looking for a job. Anybody? You will get a job this week. Come back next week and tell us that you have been given a job. God is going to heal you. Somebody came and told me that some people have come for a healing. Please know, God will heal you. And when you receive the healing, we're going to tell you how to continuously hold on to that healing. Matthew 7, verses 28. Let's go there quickly. Listen to this. I am teaching you a practical method of how to keep on believing, how to be in the faith. Amen. Go to verse 22. Let's go to keep reading that. Verse 24. Sorry. Therefore, whosoever hears these sayings of mine and doeth them, I will liken him unto a... You can read with me. Unto a... Which built his house upon a rock. Verse 25. And the rain descended, and the floods came, and the winds blew and beat upon that house, and it did not fall, because it was founded on a rock. Hallelujah. Verse 26. And everyone that heard these things and doeth them not shall be likened unto a foolish man which built his house upon the sand. Verse 27. And the rain descended, and the floods came, and the winds blew and beat upon that house, and it fell, and great was the fall of it. Verse 28. And it came to pass, when Jesus had ended these sayings, the people were astonished
at this doctrine. People of God, let me exchange a prophetic word to you. The whole world is going to go through an hour of temptation. But you and I, who are built on the rock, nothing will happen to you. Let me say that again. Oh, Pastor, you are a prophet of doom. No. The whole world is going to go through a time, a trial, a time of hour of temptation. But you and I, because we decide to obey, receive, stand on the word of God, you'll be kept safe. That's what Jesus said. He said that for all times. But there is a prophetic utterance. These are days, things may not be so good outside. Hallelujah. But you and I, because we decide to obey, stand by the word of God, we will be blessed. And my purpose of telling you that verse doesn't stop there. How to believe? By consistently saying in prayer what God has already given to you. God is going to give you healing today. You're going to be healed. How many of you believe that? Let me see your hands. Really up, really up, really up. Okay. Oh, so many of you. Okay. Now, when the Holy Spirit, I remember Pastor Verghese is saying, you have to receive it. You have to take it. How do we receive it and how do we take it? With your mouths. Lord, I thank you for the healing. I receive it and I speak it out. Even when I said that, somebody was touched. And I said, yes, sister. Somebody was touched. Receive it. Believe it. Speak it out. Many of my brothers and sisters in this church were supernaturally healed by Jesus. Healing is a gift. And this church has been so blessed by healing. Let me tell you, number one, there was a brother who was an army captain in Pakistan. His sister lives here near my father's house. She's a woman of faith. In 2010, she came and told me, Pastor, my brother, the captain, he's had a heart attack. He's in the hospital. I want to do something. I want you to pray. I said, done. We will pray. She herself did an act of faith. A week later, she called me and said, Pastor, he is totally healed. Many of my brothers and sisters sitting here have been supernaturally healed. I have seen in them two qualities. Number one, they believe the words of the Lord Jesus as is. By his stripes, I am healed. Lord, I believe it. Two, I have seen whatever the Lord telling them to do, they do. You know, when you're obedient and when you're submissive, what happens, you know? I wish I had the board ready. When you're obedient and submissive, your heart and your mind, it's okay, begins to open up like a good vessel. An open vessel is ready to receive whatever is poured into it. How do you open your heart? By submitting and obeying. Peter said, according to your word, let it be to me. Did you get that, people of God? I just told you how to receive a healing. I'm telling you how to keep it. By his stripes, we are healed. When Jesus died on the cross, God the Father put the entire curse of mankind on him. On whom? On Jesus Christ. Jesus did not stay in hell because of those sins. God the Father raised him up on the third day. What does that mean? In spite of all our sicknesses, in spite of all our curses, in spite of all those things that is put on Jesus, God still raised him up, destroying the works of the devil once and for all. And now whoever holds on to Jesus, you'll be set free. There was a time many years ago I used to think, oh, you got cancer? Ooh. The doctors used to say, you got cancer with a capital C? today to the glory of God. The people of God say, cancer, to God, that is just like common cold. Oh yeah, yeah. We have seen it. We have known it. We have seen the wonders of God. Trusting in God, I totally depending on God. For His glory, I say, for Jesus, cancer and common cold is the same. If He can heal you for your common cold, He can heal you of cancer. He can heal you of arthritis. He can heal you of everything. Because all these things was taken on the cross. Operations, mental operations. Operations. I don't feel happy. I'm feeling depressed. I'm feeling sad. Nothing is working for me. That is oppression. Sometimes the devil can bring oppressions. The devil can use a lot of mediums to bring oppression. Even scientific surveys have proved that people who spend a lot of time in front of the media, you know, the what do you call those things? Facebook and WhatsApp, and you spend a lot of time in front of the YouTube and all that, you don't know, those things which they watch begin to bring oppression. People feel so oppressed. I don't feel so good, brother. Sometimes people fall into sin and they don't know how to come out of it. They feel condemned. But people of God, there is hope. There is hope. Oppression. God is going to set you free. Sometimes we come to the end of our mind. I don't know. I don't know what to do. I am not decided. I don't know what to do. I'm not decided at all. I want to take the step to the right or to the left. One day I say, okay, I'll take the step to the left, but I can't decide. Another day I say, I take the step to the right, but then I come back to the old place. People of God, God is going to heal you. Indecision is going to be taken away. This is a problem with many people in this church. Today is going to go away. Let me tell you a secret. Are you ready to listen? Whatever you decide, God is going to be with you. Yes? You don't want to take up a job, don't take up a job. You want to take up a job, take up a job. Be decisive, then God will bring you to His place. But if you are not decided, you don't know what to do, you are staying in a no man's land. I don't know what to do. Take one step, a decisive step. God will definitely bring you to His place. This morning we heard from Brother Babukutty. Church, this is a special word for you. I want to say in the English church also. All you need to do is take one step and He will do the rest. But that step has to be a decisive step. Are you ready? Did you get what I said? Take a decisive step. Whatever it is. Those who think that they should pursue a career. Children, I'm speaking to you. Pastor, I don't know what to do. Everything has failed. Wonderful, you have come to the right place in your life. A place where God can decide things for you. I've been trying. Nothing is working. Knocking on doors. No doors are opening. Perfect, you have come to the right place. The place of Jesus. Now, He will help you to decide. Take one step. He will run all those 1,000 steps with you. But be decisive. Amen. Don't wait anymore at the table of the valley of decisions. Please, because a lot of people lose their lives in the valley of decision. Because the valley of decision is given to you to take a decision. I want to tell some of you today, have you received Jesus as the Lord of your life? Decide today for Jesus. Today may be the last day of your life. You will never know. Decide for Jesus. You may be wondering about a course to take. Should I further my education? Yes, you must. I want to tell all the young people in the church, study as much as you can. If there you feel a block, tell Jesus to break that block for you. But you decide in your heart what to do. Hello. When you are decided or decisive, God begins to open doors for you. Some of you children, start praying for the right partner in life now. Be decisive. You want to plant a church? Be decisive. You want to be a minister? Be decisive. Take that one step. God will do the rest. These are words of faith. Do it. Don't wait for circumstances. Hey, let me tell you a secret, no? A little slowly. Let me tell you a secret, please. Listen to me carefully. I know you are. Nobody is going to lift you up. Jesus alone. Church, did you hear that? Don't wait for anybody to lift you up. Don't wait for anybody to lift you up. Did you hear that? There is one person called Jesus who is interested in lifting you up. But he wants you to make a decision. Lord, I want to be in the center of your will. That's all you need to do. Because when you are lifted up, he is not going to give the glory to a man of God. One day you will say, my God lifted me up. How many of you like to say that? A lot of young pastors have helped me, but none of them will get the glory for what God is taking me to. It is me and my God. I have decided. Young people, be decisive, be decisive. Turn to your neighbor and say, be decisive, be decisive. I will become victorious. I shall be a victory. I shall be in the center of God's will. Be decisive. Be decisive. Pursue your dreams in Jesus Christ. God has given you a great future. Pursue it in Jesus' name. Run after it in Jesus' name. But he wants you to be decisive. Yes. Don't say, you know, my pastor didn't support me. My grandfather did not support me. My grandmother never said anything like this. Come out of it. Come out of it. Come out of it. Tell your mind, I am not my grandfather or grandmother. I am myself in Christ Jesus. He will stand with you. Amen. Are you ready, people of God? He's going to touch many of you today. As the worship team is going to worship, I request the whole church to be worshiping. We want to pray for some of you quickly. The Lord will do his part. We're not going to make it a big, 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 big thing. A very simple thing. Hallelujah. How many of you are ready to dance with the Lord? As you begin to worship and praise God, God is going to touch a lot of people here. Hallelujah. Yeah. In the Lord. You wrote the rhythm of life. It and heaven. Who want to be healed today, I want you to lift your hands. Those who want to be totally healed. Okay, keep those hands up. Yes. Hallelujah. Those who want to take a decision today, let it be anything. You want to start a new business? Be decided. You want to get into a new university? Be decided. When you take a decision, tell the Lord like this, Lord, I am taking a decision. I am decisive. The rest is left to you. God is going to flood, send healing. Thank you, Jesus. Okay, just call that Andy right there. Aaron, call that Andy. Andy, come here in Jesus. Come on. Let's worship the Lord.
There is power in the name of Jesus.
break every chain, break every chain, break every chain, to break every chain.
And when the chin is going away, she'll be healed completely.
Break every chain.
Set free. I pray the symptoms will also come down. I thank you because the root has been uprooted. The symptoms will also go in Jesus' name. I will translate it for you.
ਖੁਦਾਵੰਦ ਦਾਸ ਬੜਾ ਸ਼ੁਕਰ ਹੈ ਕਿ ਮੈਨੂੰ ਸ਼ਿਫਾ ਮਿਲ ਰਹੀ ਹੈ ਔਰ ਮੇਰੇ ਸ਼ਰੀਰ ਕੇ ਲਈ ਸ਼ਿਫਾ ਮਿਲੇਗੀ ਮੈਨੂੰ ਹਿੰਮਤ ਦੇਗਾ ਤਾਕਤ ਦੇਗਾ ਤੰਦਰੁਸਤੀ ਦੇਗਾ ਆਮੀਨ
She feels strongness and healing
Very good When we come into the presence of God we do feel that Ask her if she has an assurance that she has been healed of whatever she is going through
She said yes.
Absolute. Ekdam. Pakka. Hallelujah. She says she's healed. Tell her to come back and worship the Lord. Well, you saw it yourself. Well, Uncle, you wanted to pray too? Come. Yes. Keep on worshiping the Lord. Come down, come down, come down, come down. People, Jesus is doing it. And we need to worship Him. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. His truth is mighty. Leave the man. Your spirit of cancer, come out of his mouth. At once, in the name of Jesus, I command you, leave the man, leave his body. Now, yes, out of his mouth. At once.
I can read his righteousness as by the dim and flaring lamps. His day is marching on. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Our God is marching on. Our God is marching.
All the way up to the mic and come back. Something is going to happen. Go and come back. Glory, glory, hallelujah.
Glory, glory, hallelujah.
Wonderful people, they both had what the world calls something terminal, but the Lord Jesus Christ has told us there is nothing terminal in the kingdom. She said she was touched by God. Brother said he feels good. She felt very powerful. How about you, sir? You want to tell them something, what happened to you? This is not for our advertisement. No. When you say what God has done for you, you become strong. God gets the glory. It's not about us. Yes. Are you both going back with the confidence that God has healed you? Do you have the confidence? You have. Absolutely. Then I want both of them to do one thing. Keep on declaring that all, by his stripes you are healed. By the stripes of Jesus you are healed. And he has accepted Jesus. If she has not accepted Jesus, tell her to accept Jesus now and go back home. Ask her specifically, has she accepted Jesus? She's a believer. Yes, that's fine. They are both believers. God has done an amazing thing for them. They're going back in the victory of the Lord. We welcome you. Be part of this. We love people like you. It's people like you that we want to minister to. Amen. Yes. I think you stood up, right? Lift her up. This child is already healed. Not only me, many servants of God have come and said that. And I do see market changes. So this is not praying for a healing. This is, we are praying for patience for the parents and for her. Lift your hands towards her right now. You know, none of us had to go through this, what Preeta may be going through, Cyril may be going through, except Cinderella and Imran. But they have a wonderful story to say. Where's Imran? Am I right, Imran? Is God completely healing precious child? The same God will do this. We will see amazing things. I have not forgotten what I said about this child. She will be my secretary someday. I don't forget that. Come on, put your hands towards her. Thank you, Brother Vinu. Stand up and pray for the child.
കർത്താവേ, നിന്റെ സന്നിധിയിൽ ഞങ്ങൾക്ക് വരുവാൻ തന്ന കൃപയ്ക്കായി ഞങ്ങൾ നിനക്ക് സ്തോത്രം ചെയ്യുന്നു. പ്രത്യേകിച്ച് ഈ കുഞ്ഞിനെ നിദ്രകരങ്ങളിൽ വെച്ച് ഞങ്ങൾ പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്നു കർത്താവേ. ആ കൊടുത്തിരിക്കുന്ന സൗഖ്യത്തിനായി സ്തോത്രം കർത്താവേ, സൗഖ്യമയച്ചതിനായി സ്തോത്രം. നിന്റെ അടിപ്പിണരുകളാൽ ഞങ്ങൾക്ക് സൗഖ്യം വന്നുവെന്ന് പറയുവാൻ നീ ഞങ്ങളെ സഹായിക്കുന്ന വലിയ കൃപയ്ക്കായി സ്തോത്രം കർത്താവേ. നിന്റെ അടിപ്പിണരുകൾ കർത്താവേ ഇപ്പോഴും കർത്താവേ ആക്റ്റീവായിട്ടിരിക്കുന്നതിനായി സ്തോത്രം കർത്താവേ. നീ അനേക രോഗികളെ സൗഖ്യമാക്കിക്കൊണ്ടിരിക്കുന്നതിനായി സ്തോത്രം ചെയ്യുന്നു. ഈ കുഞ്ഞിൻ്റെ സൗഖ്യം ഞങ്ങൾ കാണാൻ പോകുന്നതിനായി സ്തോത്രം. വിശ്വാസത്താൽ ഞങ്ങളത് പ്രഖ്യാപിക്കുമ്പോൾ കർത്താവേ, നീ അവിടുന്ന് സൗഖ്യമാക്കുന്ന കാര്യങ്ങൾക്കായി സ്തോത്രം. ഈ കുടുംബത്തെ ഞങ്ങൾ അനുഗ്രഹിച്ച് പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്നു കർത്താവേ. ഇവരുടെ അനുഗ്രഹ വിഷയമായി തീരുന്നതിനായി സ്തോത്രം ചെയ്യുന്നു, സ്തുതിക്കുന്നു. ഇവരുടെ അനുഗ്രഹമായി തീരുന്നതിനായി സ്തോത്രം ചെയ്യുന്നു കർത്താവേ. നീ ഒരു അനുഗ്രഹ വിഷയമാക്കി ഇവരെ തീർത്തതിനായി സ്തോത്രം കർത്താവേ. ഈ കുഞ്ഞിനെ പറ്റിയുള്ള പ്രൊഫസി എല്ലാം അവിടുന്ന് വാസ്തവമാക്കി തീർക്കാൻ പോകുന്നതിനായി സ്തോത്രം ചെയ്യുന്നു, സ്തുതിക്കുന്നു കർത്താവേ. ഇതൊരു സെക്രട്ടറി ആയിട്ട് തന്നെ തീരാൻ പോകുന്നതിനായി സ്തോത്രം ചെയ്യുന്നു, സ്തുതിക്കുന്നു കർത്താവ്. അവിടുന്ന് സംഗതി തന്നെ വരുത്തുന്നതിനായി സ്തോത്രം കർത്താവേ. വിശ്വാസികളുടെ വിശ്വാസത്തോടു കൂടിയുള്ള പ്രാർത്ഥന നീ അവിടുന്ന് മാനിച്ചിരിക്കുന്നതിനായി സ്തോത്രം ചെയ്യുന്നു, സ്തുതിക്കുന്നു കർത്താവേ. ഞങ്ങൾ ഈ കുഞ്ഞിനെ അനുഗ്രഹിച്ചു പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്നു കർത്താവേ. സൗഖ്യം അയച്ചതിനായി സ്തോത്രം, യേശുവിൻ നാമത്തിൽ തന്നെ.
Hallelujah. Thank you. Young people, many of you do not say this out, but you go through a lot of oppressions. You go through temptations. You're going to be set free right now. Many of you young people spending a lot of time in front of social media apparatuses, apps, Facebook, WhatsApp, YouTube. It's okay to watch all these things, but if you are in a situation where you can never pull yourself out of this, you need a deliverance. I get into the Facebook once in 6 months. I use the WhatsApp for good things, but hey, let me tell you, time is so important. When you think you are spending a lot of time in front of this, you need a deliverance. Amen. Hello. And young people, you need deliverance from some of the besetting sins. Besetting sins means, you know, some of the sins which we can't speak out here in openly, but some dirty things in the dark, you need to be set free. Many of you, do I hear an amen from everybody? God wants holiness inside and outside, in every area of your life. He's going to set you free. Set you free. So I want all the young people who are not married, every one of you to stand up right now. All the young people who are not married, I want you all to stand up right now. God is going to send a fire on you. All of you young people, you think you are, you may not be addicted, but still I'm telling you, I want all the young people to stand. Yes, you're not married. All kinds of temptations you may have. You may be feeling condemned about something, but Jesus is going to set you free. Thank you, Jesus. Okay, close your eyes. Can you quietly tell the Lord like this? Lord Jesus, our lives are precious to you. And we surrender our lives to you in a very special way. Keep us holy. Keep us separated from the world. Give us moral strength and courage that we may never have to be ashamed in front of anybody. Keep us away from addictions, Lord. Please set us free and help us to live with you as our Lord. That we may not lose time in this world. That we may turn around to become assets to the kingdom of God. That we may become assets to our parents. Use us, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. As you close your eyes, as you have said that prayer, truly, God's Holy Spirit is faithful to come and fall on you. You never were an addict. You have no such problems. Good. Still receive the Holy Spirit because you need Him to keep you. To some of the children, this thought is coming to me from the Lord. It is not your merit, but the Lord has kept you from big, big, big temptations. It is the Lord who kept you, children. You did not know it.
I'm going to tell you something. In the night times when you are sleeping, because some of you, your thoughts and your minds went astray, that is an open door for the devil to come in the night to take your thoughts away. But the Lord kept you. The Lord protected you because of his covenant with your parents. Because of his covenant with you, he is faithful. Children, every time before you go to bed, as a father, I tell you, pray and sleep. Lord, purify my thoughts. Purify my mind. Help me to sleep a good sleep. I don't want to say, but some of you young children, you do not have even a good sleep. Even when your eyes are closed throughout the night, you are twisting and turning. But today it's going to come to an end. Whoever you are, you're restless inside your mind and your heart because of these kind of things. But today God is going to set you free. All of you children, will you lift your hands? And all of your parents, everybody, will you bless them right now? Our children are, children, lift your hands, all of you, every one of you. Please pray for them right now. Come on, open your mouth and speak in tongues and pray. Pray, pray, pray for your children. Pray for your children. That their thoughts and their minds shall be guarded under the Holy Ghost and the power of God. They shall be guarded by the word of God. They shall be protected by the blood of the Lamb. No demon can touch a person covered by the blood of the Lamb. These are our children. They are precious to us. Every one of them. Very precious to us. God will guard them and protect them. He will keep them. And now, keep on praying, people of God. Keep on praying, people of God. Keep on praying. Some of the children are so hungry, they don't know it. They are spiritually so dry, they don't know it. Hallelujah. Bonnie, put your hand around AJ. Yes. Yes, there is an impartation coming on him. Put your hand around him. He is a son of this house. God has great plans for him. When sometimes I cry, it is not my tears, but it is the tears of the Lord that comes through me, I know. God has great plans for you, children. Sons and daughters of this house. God has amazing plans for you. And the enemy cannot stop God's plans for you. Many of you children, oh Jesus. In Jesus' name, Spirit. Thank you. Thank you. Jesus Christ is Lord. Nobody else can take that place. Jesus Christ is Lord. Every hurting youngster, teenager, young people, let me tell you, Pastor Shiju has been through a lot of problems, but Jesus brought me out of this. Pastor Shiju has seen a lot of struggle at your age, but Jesus brought me out of this. That's my testimony. Many young people, the age of your fathers and mothers, they will tell you they also have been through much temptation, but the Lord kept us. The same God, He will lift you up. He's a God of love. He's a God of compassion. And He will set you right. Yes, thank you, Jesus. Father, we humbly ask you that you will protect these children. Break away every addictive habits from them if they have it. Lord, many of them do not know what to do in the face of temptation. The world has taught them that it is okay to sin. And even when they are guilty, sometimes they fall into these kind of habits, these kind of sins. But today, Lord, please tell our children what is acceptable to you and what is not acceptable to you. Lord, we don't want the world to teach our children what is right. We want the Holy Spirit to teach them. We want the Word of God to teach them what is right. Lord, they are among people who do not know you. In their universities, in their colleges, in their classrooms, in their workplaces. They are influenced by or likely to be influenced by a lot of people who do not know you. And Lord, we believe it's the job of the church to tell them what is right and wrong. Holy Spirit of God, we commit these wonderful children into your hands. Lord, Daddy, please flush out every evil thought that is in their hearts and minds. Every deposit that has fallen into them without in their innocence, Lord, through the words of their friends. Everything that has been deposited in the back of their mind, Father, when they were watching a lot of these movies, a lot of these YouTube presentations, which is ungodly. protect them, Lord. Protect them, Lord. Protect them. Some of you children, I want to tell you like this. If you think that your friend, whoever your friend is keeping you away from the things of God, if you think that your friend is keeping you away from your education, keep away from that friend. If your friendship is keeping you away from being a part of God's church, being a part of His move, keep away from that friend. Because your eternity is greater than your friend. Thank you, Jesus, for hearing our prayers. Thank you, Lord, for this ministry. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Thank you, precious sons and daughters. Please be seated. Let's stand up in God's presence when I come down. This final song we'll sing, and thank you for your time. And I stand in overview. I stand in overview. Holy God, to whom all praise is due.
I stand in awe of you.
And I stand in awe of you. And
I stand in awe of you. As of praises,
I stand in awe of you. You are beautiful beyond description. Too marvelous for words, too wonderful for comprehension, like nothing ever seen or heard. So good, give us Jesus. And Jesus, thank you for coming into this world and dying for us on the cross. Father, thank you for raising Jesus up. No sin, no sickness is too big for you. Thank you for the hand of healing that you have shown today, and the promise by which you said, the hand of the one who does amazing things is with you. Let people be lifted up. Lord, let those who are oppressed be totally free. Bless Philadelphia. Bless the United States of America in a very special way. Thank you. We love you. In Jesus' name we pray. The people of God said, and the people of God said, and the people of God said, Amen. Hallelujah. Give the Lord a clap offering.